Good morning, Tennessee Valley. Welcome to this Tuesday morning, bright and sunny. Wait a minute. It's probably raining outside.
I don't know. I can't see.
I know. We're in a dungeon. We're inside in this dungeon, so we don't know what's going on outside, but it's supposed to rain today.
It's hopefully very clear and
It was wet this morning when we drove in.
It's true.
But it might not be raining. Maybe the sun's out right now.
Maybe it is.
Right?
Could be.
I am with the ever lovely and beautiful and smart and funny. And, this is Sarah. Sarah Anderson.
Good morning, everyone.
Sarah, how are you?
I'm doing well. Now I'm kind of concerned. I'm wondering if there's some big bomb you're going to drop or you're
going to
try and kill me later.
No, I'm really just happy to be here.
I'm glad. That's why he's off. He's happy. He doesn't know how to deal with that emotion.
I'm not usually happy. I'm happy to see you. I haven't seen you for like 2 weeks.
I know. It's a long time for us.
And so how are you doing? What's
I'm
up?
I'm doing really well.
What's up?
I actually yesterday said goodbye to a friend who was leaving for the Air Force. So
Leaving for the Air Force? Where are they
going?
Well,
for boot camp.
Oh, yeah. For boot camp. Mm-hmm. Okay. In the Air Force. Do Air Force people actually have boot camp?
They do. I know. It's weird. Yeah. Air Force does.
Do they wear boots? I guess they do.
Probably. They stomp around in them.
They
you know, the majority of people in the Air Force.
They just go like this because they're flying a plane.
The majority of people in the Air Force are not actually airmen, so.
Oh, really?
Mm-mm.
Well, what's the point of calling it
the
Air Force?
There are a lot of other positions other than
pilots.
If
they're not in the Air Force.
You have to have people to work on the planes. You have to have people navigating.
So your friend, is it a man or a woman?
It's a woman. Her name's Kayla.
Kayla?
Excuse me.
So Kayla's going to be doing what? What does she want to do?
I'm honestly not sure. She's a friend of a friend, but we became friends. Is
she going to work on the planes?
I'm not sure
yet.
I know
fly
she has
the
tech
planes?
School after boot camp.
Actually, isn't the Honor Guard at the White House and also at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, aren't they Air Force people?
For some reason, I thought they were Marines, but they might be. I could be completely incorrect.
I went to the, Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, and I saw the people, but I can't
I think
remember.
You're right, they are.
Because I'm not familiar enough with military
I had a friend
personnel.
Who went to the Air Force, and he ended up in D.C. to do something Honor Guard related, so I guess you're probably correct.
Have you ever been to the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier?
We have so many veterans right now who are upset with us.
I know. Well, I mean, we appreciate what they do so much.
Yes.
I don't know why they could be upset with us. We exist because they have protected us.
And yes, to answer your question, I have been to the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier.
Isn't that really cool, the way that they do that? And they walk so slowly, and you know, it's all timed.
Yeah.
It's all timed out, and then they do this, they move their legs, then they go clunk, and like this, and then clunk, and then they do that, and then they just walk. And each person walks for 1 hour, and that's it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, then maybe they walk more than once, but they don't do it but like once a week or something like that. It's really interesting. So I thought that was very interesting. I was in Nashville this last week.
What were you in Nashville for?
I was in that for a Phi Theta Kappa convention.
Oh, yeah. How was that?
It was very interesting, very good. I got to see, are you familiar with Amy Chua? She wrote a book called Battle Hymn
so she's
of
an
the
author.
Battle Hymn of the Tiger Mom. Have you not heard of this?
No.
Oh, it's fantastic.
Sounds like I should have.
She's
though.
Of Chinese descent or okay. something, and she decided to
Asian descent. Is that what you're going?
She
for?
Made a comment that said she used to live in the Philippines, and I was like, well, if she was in the Philippines, then is she from China or is she from Filipino?
Oh, okay.
Anyway, she wrote a book called Battle Hymn of the Tiger Mom, and she decided to raise her two daughters as a Chinese mother would raise
United States.
But raise them in the
That's
United
awesome.
States. And it's very, very strict.
That would be an interesting cultural study to do.
Yes, it was very interesting. And then I also got to see Malcolm Gladwell speak. You know who Malcolm Gladwell is? He is also an author.
Okay.
He wrote books called The Tipping Point,
okay.
Blink, Outliers.
Yes, I've heard all of them.
You've heard of those books, yes. Very influential, very psychological, very sociological in what he talks about. And so he's one of my favorite authors. And so when I got to see him speak, I was really, really excited.
Which of his books would you recommend most? I'm looking for new genres. I'm trying to break
Probably out. Outliers, I think, is a good introduction.
Okay.
I've not read Blink, but I hear that Blink is fantastic. But you may need the setup of Outliers first. What he talks about outliers is those exceptional people, like you and myself, that are so exceptional that they are That they're just like the Bill Gateses and the Steve Jobs.
They don't fit in their normal.
Right, they're not the normal. They're outliers. They're just so exceptional. And it talks about some of the principles behind what makes them outliers.
Okay.
And he said that it's not, a lot of people just think, well, they're talented or they're lucky. And it's not really about that. There are other things that go into it. And the book is really fantastic.
That sounds really interesting.
Really fantastic. But anyway, he spoke and got to see him. And then our students got to go and they got to learn about what Phi Theta Kappa is, which is, it is an honor society. It's for two-year colleges. Mm-hmm. And so they have to have high GPA and do lots of innovative and creative things and also impactful things for the community and stuff like that.
That's awesome. So, speaking of impactful things for the community, this week is Volunteer Appreciation Week.
So really?
I would like to thank any volunteers that I've ever had the pleasure of working with. Which was
Volunteer Appreciation Week.
Just recognizing the volunteers.
Right.
And that is also within the month of Child Abuse Prevention Awareness Month.
Which is this month.
Which is this month, April.
Interesting.
So.
See, I don't volunteer. I don't do anything without compensation.
That doesn't surprise me, Matt.
Why not? That's all right. I'm an open book.
That's
I'm an open
true.
Book.
Are you not the, you're the advisor for Phi Theta Kappa, correct?
That's true, that's true.
So you are getting trips out of that.
I'm getting, yeah, I get to go to Nashville. Last year I went to Seattle. The year before that I went to Orlando.
Oh, wow.
They give me free food.
Seattle, that's
awesome.
Yeah,
they give me free food. They, yeah, and it helps me. Yeah, no, I don't do anything without compensation, except for the show, actually.
That's true, the show is...
It's all volunteer.
Completely lacking compensation, yes.
But you are someone who volunteering is a big part of your life.
I mean, the organizations that I've worked for, all of them post-college, have all been based in volunteer fuel.
Yeah.
I mean, Invisible Children, definitely, Habitat, and CASA are all run by volunteers,
but they are populated by volunteers.
Yeah, wouldn't work without volunteers.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So that's a big part of your life. So I want to thank you.
Well, I would like to thank them.
For all the volunteering you do and all of the volunteering that other people do. That's not true, actually. I do volunteer at the Y as well.
So you're... So I'm I was kind about of a, to say, you're not...
I'm kind of a volunteer. So I'd like to thank myself.
Well, that's one thing that I love about...
Thank you, Matt, for the volunteering that I've done.
Oh, thank you, Matt. Thank you, Matt.
Oh, all right. See, I was fishing for that.
I mean, something really that I love about Cleveland and Bradley County in this area is that there is that volunteerism type of spirit here.
Yeah.
And that's what brought me back here. And
actually, I volunteer for the United Way as well.
Of course you do. Look at you.
Well, I have to. Well, that is not really volunteering. It's forced volunteering. Ryerson is the president of the United Way, and he makes me do that.
He's mean like that.
He's just very
Matt,
domineering.
Matt, you must help people.
Very controlling. He's like, Talbert, you got to do this. And I'm
and
like, yes, sir. Yes,
he's
so
influential is a better term.
Influential, yes. Right, right. He holds a gun to my head. I know.
He doesn't seem to be one for violence. I doubt that.
You'd be surprised. You'd be surprised. Yeah. He's got a little son. He's trying to raise his son to be violent. Actually, I am totally blowing smoke. Matt actually is raising his son to be nonviolent.
To be
Literally, to be nonviolent. He is teaching his son to use words instead of violence, and he's told me many, many stories about how his son will avoid violence in order to do something nonviolent, and he's just so proud. He
that's
said, if
awesome.
My son becomes like a chess player, I'll be just so happy because
that's so
he's
peaceful
nonviolent.
And, yeah.
Matt and Heather both, the Ryersons, are very much about that idea. Me, on the other hand,
violence.
I love violence. You give me violence and I will give it back to you. That's what I am all about.
Oh, Matthew.
Let's take a look at the weather and actually see if it's raining outside right now.
I don't know.
Yes. Storms and raining outside. High of only 73, low of 46. Storms tomorrow as well, high of 77 and 45. I knew storms were coming in yesterday, but I wasn't sure about today.
Yes.
And there were some left over, and I thought there might be a break. And then Thursday, cloudy with a high of 81. It's been pretty mild, not too hot, not too bad.
It's more like spring weather the last couple of weeks.
Which
we're
has been
actually
really
seeing
nice.
More of the type of weather we should have been seeing in March and April.
Exactly.
Which you and I love, because we need to create some sort of organization. People for proper weather.
That's a very good idea. That's a very good idea. We'll what we need to do is we need to create a big bubble. And just go live
exclude
in the bubble.
Everyone that does not appreciate.
No, no, we invite people in there, but it's climate control. It's climate control. See, when I was in.
I think that there are, you know, books and films that have been made off of that theory.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, let's read some of those.
Climate controlled. Okay, sure.
I used to work in climate controlled buildings. See, out in the Northwest in Washington State, they have these. They do a lot of orchards, apples and cherries, and they store them in these climate controlled buildings. And so I used to work in some of these in the middle of the summer, and it would be like 50 degrees inside. It was so wonderful to do that, except when they were not functioning. And then they got even hotter inside than they were outside, so it was really rough. Yeah. But they have those. I'd like to live in a climate-controlled building.
Is that much different than having an air conditioning or...
If you work at Cleveland State, it is.
Oh, that's true.
Cleveland State's their air conditioning doesn't work all that well. Well, I'm glad that you had a good weekend seeing your friend off, and yes. I had a very fun weekend. I was a little disappointed. Didn't get to see my daughter over the weekend because I had to go up there by myself. So when I got back, there was a lot of hanging out
happy,
with her that happened. Happy
dad-daughter time.
And I was just like, Daddy, I want to give you a hug. And
that's
so I
awesome.
Gave her a lot of hugs yesterday. But I am back now, and I'm happy to be back, and I'm happy that you're with us. And when we come back, we are going to have somebody from Cleveland State here. Ron Page, who is our Director of Instructional Technology here, has some news about a summer event that's coming up.
Oh, awesome.
Where you can learn about, teachers can learn about technology. So we are going to find out more about that. Please stick around. We will be right back.
I'm Wes Robbins with Landmark Insurance Brokerage. When it comes to employee benefits, we've got you covered. Call me today for the best service and best solutions to your group health and employee benefits needs. At Landmark Insurance Brokerage, we've got you covered.
Discover great local programming right here on WTMB East Tennessee Television. Tune in weekday mornings at 6:30 a.m. for Tennessee Valley This Morning to find out what's going on in your local area. Watch East Tennessee Shopper with Joe and Kim Palo live every Monday night from 7 to 8 p.m. Be caught up in all the latest sports action. Watch In the Spotlight with Brittany Jackson Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. with replays at midnight. All this and more on WTNB East Tennessee Television.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dennis Ford, board certified in anti-aging medicine and pain management. Have you had recent decrease in energy, lack of sex drive, feel moody, grumpy, or sad? If so, you may have low testosterone and be a candidate for bioidentical hormone replacement. Listen to what two of my patients have to say.
Before I came to the Ford Clinic, I had to have a nap every day.
When I got off work, I'd lay around, really didn't want to do much, and felt real lazy.
I've noticed since I had the testosterone implant, that I can go a good 8 hours doing the things I enjoy doing.
I had it done, took about 25, 30 minutes, 5 months, and I'm doing good. My stomach, my muscles, they've completely changed. My fat level has dropped. Get to go out and run, exercise with my son. My muscles are just getting stronger.
If you'd like to change your life, please call me at Ford Center for Pain Management and Anti-Aging Medicine at 423-400-9115.
Very simple process, and is well worth it.
Welcome back to Tennessee Valley This Morning. It's good to see you. It's good to be seen by you. And I'm here with Sarah Anderson, our co-host. But more importantly, we have Ron Page, who is Director of Instructional Technology here at Cleveland State. And you're here to come talk to us about teaching with technology or something of some sort.
It will be the third annual Summer Summit for Teaching with Technology. And every year we've been doubling in size. So I'm hoping that this year we double in size again, which would put us at over between 400 and 500 attendees.
Wow, that's huge.
Yeah.
That is huge. We're, as far as I know, the fastest growing technology conference in the state. and we're picking up a lot of support. The State Ed is one of our biggest supporters. The Tennessee Board of Regents is now a partner with us. We have actually a whole week of events, but the actual P16 Summer Summit is Wednesday, June 6th.
Just a day-long day, but you have events all week long.
It's a day-long day.
It's a long day for you, probably, and your staff. Yeah. So now when we talk about technology, now education is moving that direction, the use of technology. What kind of technology are we talking about?
The nice part here is that we leave it up to people to make proposals on what they see happening in their own educational venue, whether it's at college, K-12, pre-K. What do they see going on as far as technology changing the face or the structure of education?
I see. Then
they make proposals and they say, well, this is what I think people need to know more about. And we get phenomenal proposals. Rather than me trying to dictate, I let the people tell us what they're seeing happening in education, and then to put together a 50-minute or 110-minute presentation that they come and do for instructors, for teachers. And as a result, we get a really good cross-section. Right now I have 50 different presenters and about 80 different breakout sessions that will be occurring during that Wednesday.
Wow, that's fantastic to have it right here, Cleveland State's campus. They're probably all over the campus then. If you have that many breakout sessions, you probably put them all over in all the different buildings. Now, we're not talking just computers,
which
is obviously, the computers have been around and are starting to be used more and more. But we're also maybe talking about handheld devices. Tablets are starting to be used, but then also like
smart boards.
You're talking about all the different kinds of technology that could be used in a situation like this.
Absolutely. In fact, because I put all this together, I know what most of the people are doing presentations on. iPads are big right now.
Yeah.
Mobile apps will be a huge part of this. Promethean boards, smart boards. Another technology that most people haven't seen is the projection smart board. Dell has one, for example, where you can use a regular whiteboard, dry erasable whiteboard,
yeah,
and turn it into a quote-unquote smart board.
Because normally the smart boards have the technology built into them,
right,
that you then project and it's all connected. But you're saying is that the projector can watch what you do and then...
Wow.
That is amazing.
It has a video camera in it, and it sees what you're doing, brings it back, stores it on your computer, and you can interact just through the projector, which means I actually can have a quote-unquote smart board any place I have a dry erase whiteboard. Yep.
That is
really cool. Now, that's kind of like Xbox Kinect. Have you heard about Xbox Kinect?
That would be that same
same type of technology. We have one, and there's this dancing game, and then you dance in front of the camera.
I would
camera.
Love to see you do that, Matt.
No, you would not.
Can we do that on
No, I'm not going. No, thank you.
No, you go to the Cleveland State website, and you watch our president, Carl Hyde.
Yes, right? Yes. He's doing some dancing there now. Yeah, he puts some
dancing. That's impressive.
We have a QEP, and he did it.
I had friends who did it at their wedding for their first dance. Really? Instead of a normal dance, they
danced with Kinect? Mm-hmm. That's hilarious. But so it watches you, and then it can read what you do, and that's what you're talking about, this projector being
right.
able to do for teachers. That would basically... Then you would only have to buy the projector. You wouldn't have to buy a board,
correct.
I guess, is the difference.
And it's about
there.
Half the price of the board,
yeah,
because the technology isn't being trying to be compressed into this big board that gets mounted on the wall. And you mentioned Kinect. We actually have a presentation using Kinect.
Really?
I know of at least one. There might be more than one.
That is awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, now, I've actually seen that kind of technology. See, you can actually... talk to the Xbox, and aside from pushing the on button, you would not have to use a controller to do anything else. You can speak to it, and it'll do everything for you you want it to do, start this game or whatever. And so this technology being used, I'm glad that they're being able to do this in the classroom. I think it's just going to be so much easier for teachers to have that projector, set it up anywhere, and then just go to town. That's great.
And most of the presentations are being done by people that actually, in fact, all of the presentations that I know of are being done by people that are actually using this technology in the classroom. So you're getting it right from the source. Many of them are hands-on. We're doing them in our labs. I have special rooms that are being set up. And then, of course, we do have a vendor area, a sponsor area, where sponsors will be set up. And these are big-name sponsors. Cengage, Desire to Learn. These are international sponsors that have taken an interest in this. They'll be setting up presentations with their equipment and doing demonstrations. Also, the focal point is the gym. That's where the registration, the sign-in is. The people will come there. Pick up their badges. They pre-register online at the Cleveland State website. There's a real colorful P16 logo. You have to scroll down. It's in the right-hand corner down at the bottom. But register, and man, I love doing the evaluations at the end of this event because people just rave about it, and it is. Where I came from 7 years ago, New York State, I had just done the first one of these before I moved here. Mm. It was hugely successful, but you know, you always need the spark plug. They dropped the ball, and now it's here in Tennessee.
Yeah.
This is growing very, very quickly, and I expect this to continue to grow because there is a huge need for it.
Now, you mentioned TBR, Tennessee Board of Regents. So is this being advertised to all of the schools across Tennessee? Are we getting, you're going to get people from there, or is it primarily just a local thing right now?
I'd like to keep it regional. It is statewide as far as TBR is concerned, because we have presenters and attendees coming from the other side of the state. I know people from Memphis, Dyersburg, for example, mm-hmm. that have already registered.
Great.
So yes, it is statewide. As far as the K-12 population, though, I would like to keep it regional.
Right.
That's why we're focusing on a one-day event, so you can drive in and drive back. So I'd like to stay within a two-hour drive.
Sure.
So people have access. And we are getting instructors coming. We have a whole bunch of presenters coming in from Knoxville, for example.
Great.
From the school systems up there. We have presenters coming in, of course, from the from Hamilton County, for example. But I would like it to be regional. That way we can attend to the specific needs of those instructors who tend to be somewhat in rural areas, for example.
We have a lot of that in Southeast Tennessee. We got Polk and Meigs and McMinn counties are all pretty rural in nature. They have a big town. They have a town, but that's about it. Yeah.
Sure. So if we can be regional, that gives somebody else the opportunity to pick up the central part of the state and the western part of the state, and we could link these conferences together, which I think would be really nifty.
Wow, that is great. This is a bright star, I think, for Bradley County and, of course, for Cleveland State to have something of this caliber with this kind of people coming in to do these presentations and really kind of setting the standard for where education is going now in the 21st century. I think it's fantastic. Now, you said if people want to register, if they're a teacher and they want to see some of this, they want to be involved, go to the Cleveland State website.
Right.
So that's clevelandstatecc.edu.
Correct.
And then down at the bottom of the page on the right-hand side is a P16.
Right.
Logo there.
Real colorful, because we started this by saying Cleveland doesn't have a beach, but, and that was our original motto in the very beginning.
Yeah.
So what we started to do is play on this Hawaiian theme. And last year, a bunch of us wore Hawaiian shirts as presenters. This year, all presenters get a Hawaiian shirt.
So
they will all have a Hawaiian
shirt.
So they stand out. And that's how the Southern Luau Luncheon originated. Last year, we let people have a break and go get their own lunch, and everybody said, look, we'll pay a little bit more if you provide the food and we can stay right there on campus. So rather than having a sandwich spread, we decided, let's stay with the theme. Let's do a luau luncheon.
Very cool.
And add that in.
Very cool. That's great. So it sounds like the food's going to be good.
Yeah. Can we sneak into that?
What is the cost for someone who wants to attend the P16?
For the first 2 years, the cost was $20. This year, The cost is only for early bird. They can go in, and if they work with their school, it's $35. Mm. All we did is add the cost of the luau luncheon to that.
Okay, great.
But it's still much bigger. Last year, we thought we were big with 40 breakout sessions. This year, we'll have somewhere between 70 and 80 breakout sessions. So the selection is bigger. The overall quality of the presentations, in my opinion, is unsurpassed. And I go to conferences. I present at least two conferences a year. And you'd have to go to a conference that you spent $400, $500, $600 to register for to find this kind of quality in the presentation.
Yeah, I was just at a Phi Theta Kappa conference, and that was the registration was over $300 for that, and it's a pretty big conference, 4,000 people. So yeah, $35 for the kind of thing that we're getting here is pretty reasonable. So that is great. Well, fantastic. Well, Ron, thanks for coming on and showing us. And I am now the date. What is the date? I didn't ask you that.
June 6th.
June 6th.
It's a Wednesday.
Okay.
Yep. And people pre-register online. Stop in, pick up their badges. We'll be open from 7 to 8, and then we have a phenomenal keynote speaker. For anybody that knows Dr. Robbie Melton, you know you're in for a treat as a keynote.
Yeah.
She's definitely good. Is exciting.
She is really good. So June 6th, all day long, that's a Wednesday.
Yep.
$35, very reasonable. So if you're a local educator and you want to get on the ground floor of understanding what where technology is going in education, then you need to sign up for that. Go to clevelandstatecc.edu. Down to the bottom of the page, hit the P16 logo and register. Love to have you. Thanks, Ron, for coming in here and let us know about this.
It's exciting.
We will take a break, and when we come back, Sarah Anderson will regale us with the up and comings of what's happening in entertainment at this point. So stick around. You do not want to miss that.
Discover great local programming right here on WTMB East Tennessee Television. Tune in weekday mornings at 6:30 a.m. for Tennessee Valley This Morning to find out what's going on in your local area. Watch East Tennessee Shopper with Joe and Kim Palo live every Monday night from 7 to 8 p.m. Be caught up in all the latest sports action. Watch In the Spotlight with Brittany Jackson Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. with replays at midnight. All this and more on WTNB East Tennessee Television.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dennis Ford, board certified in anti-aging medicine and pain management. Have you had recent decrease in energy, lack of sex drive, feel moody, grumpy, or sad? If so, you may have low testosterone and be a candidate for bioidentical hormone replacement. Listen to what two of my patients have to say.
Before I came to the Ford Clinic, I had to have a nap every day.
When I got off work, I'd lay around, really didn't want to do much, and felt real lazy.
I've noticed since I had the testosterone implant that I could go a good 8 hours doing the things I enjoy doing.
I had it done, took about 25, 30 minutes, 5 months, and I'm doing good. My stomach, my muscles, they've completely changed. My fat level has dropped. Get to go out and run, exercise with my son. My muscles are just getting stronger.
If you'd like to change your life, please call me at Ford Center for Pain Management and Anti-Aging Medicine at 423-400-9115.
It's a very simple process and is well worth it.
I'm Wes Robbins with Landmark Insurance Brokerage. When it comes to employee benefits, we've got you covered. Call me today for the best service and best solutions to your group health and employee benefits needs. At Landmark Insurance Brokerage, we've got you covered.
Welcome back, Tennessee Valley, and this is what I've been waiting for 2 weeks to finally hear. So, did you see my?
I have not seen your.
I did the entertainment segment last week. And from apparently, from what Jennifer James tells me, it was extremely mediocre. It was actually a little uncomfortable. And so
I gave you good material last week.
You gave me great material, but I
horrible.
Yeah, I needed you, and I need you now. So tell me, what's going on?
That's sweet, Matt.
Oh, all right. Yeah. So just tell me about what's going on here.
I'm trying to make him uncomfortable. We have again this week the good, the bad, and the ugly.
Ah.
So the good, Brangelina is engaged.
I heard that. Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie. Fantastic.
Finally engaged.
Now, Brad Pitt once said he would never get married again.
Okay, well, I don't know about that claim.
Okay.
The claim that he made in 2006 was that they would not be getting married until there was marriage equality. So.
Oh, okay.
And so this was a while back, and he's saying now that, you know, that was that statement they made was a long time ago, and that they still believe in that, but that their kids, and they have, I mean, they have six kids together. So their kids are wanting, you know, they're asking questions. They want to know why their parents aren't married. So they, you know, he popped the question in whatever form that happened, which has not been released, by the way.
How he has popped the question?
So, yeah. But I'm sure, I mean.
Well, then, so they didn't wait for full-on marriage equality. Marriage equality being anyone can marry anybody else no matter what, as long as it's another human being.
Right? Yes, same-sex marriages being
the main,
allowed.
The main issue, yeah.
Of course, yeah, I don't know. The way you described that was interesting. But
well,
yes.
Some people, when they hear marriage equality, meaning, well, what if I want to marry my pig?
Yeah,
what
no, if I'm glad you clarified the as long as it's another human being.
Another human being,
yeah,
that's what I'm talking about.
Things are definitely not
because,
equal.
Like, what was his name? Dennis Rodman marry himself or something like that? He tried
know.
To marry
yeah,
himself.
Yeah, something
See,
foolish.
I mean, you have those crazies mm-hmm. out there. The only thing you're specifically talking about is humans marrying other humans.
Marrying humans, yeah. Yes, exactly.
Other humans who are not
humans
themselves.
Humans are not, yeah. And who would, oh, Dennis
But that, now, that's not actually happened in America, and there's
no,
still a lot of debate.
In a lot of states, you know.
There's still a lot of
still,
debate over
yeah,
that.
A lot of things going on.
But they have decided to go forward
They've
with it.
Yes, due to, you know, their own family.
And make their marriage honorable.
Yes, and there was question whether or not the LGBT community would be accepting of that, but apparently all the equality groups that have been involved with Brangelina before are very supportive and have said, you know, this is
As
great.
As if anyone else has a say over whether or not two people get married.
I know. Oh, well, isn't that an interesting concept?
Yeah. Oh,
As if anyone else has a say. Anyway, so moving on. Also the good, the Avengers premiere happened.
Oh, it happened. Well, the premiere happened. It's not released yet.
Yes, the release of it is April 4th.
It's supposed to be, this movie is supposed to be fabulous.
It's supposed to be, you know,
because I've seen all of them.
Good comic
I saw Avengers. I didn't see Avengers. I saw the Thor, Captain America, Iron Man, Spider-Man. Is Spider-Man going to be in there? The Last Hulk. I saw all of those.
The Hulk, yes.
They were all good. Mm-hmm. So now they're bringing them all together into
The Avengers.
The Avengers.
I'm not excited at all.
You're not?
No.
You liar.
I'm so excited. May 4th. Excited. The Bad. On this week's Dancing with the Stars. Okay, did you ever watch Growing Up? Well, I don't know when it would have come out in relation to your growing up.
Thank you. I'm old. I understand. I understand that. I'm old. Go ahead.
Little House on the Prairie. Melissa Gilbert.
Actually, I did kind of watch it, but it was older than I was.
Okay, good
But
to
I
know.
Did end up watching
growing up,
it.
Reruns, I watched reruns.
Yeah,
yeah.
My mom
and I read the books. I'm a big
I never
fan
read the books.
Of Laura Ingalls Wilder. Well, that's understandable. They were more
Girly.
Geared toward girls, yeah. Yeah. I've read them all.
But my mom used to watch The Little House on the Prairie, and so I'd watch it with her sometimes.
Well, Melissa Gilbert is now on Dancing with the Stars, which
right.
I do not follow, but many people do. Have you watched it at all?
No, well,
I watched
a couple of episodes, but I'm not real big into it. My daughter, on the other hand.
Oh, really?
See, I watch The Voice, which is the singing competition. I think that's fabulous. I think it's a great competition because it's a whole lot better than American Idol.
Yeah.
Because you actually get people
it's
who know what
yeah.
they're doing. And and I watch that. It comes on the same time. And my daughter will be sitting there and we'll be watching The Voice. And then she's like, Daddy. And I said, what? And she, I want to tell you something. I say, okay, tell me. And she says, I watch Dancing with Stars.
Oh.
She doesn't like The Voice. She wants to see the dancing.
So do you switch? Are you nice? Do you at least during commercials?
No, absolutely not. No, no.
Oh, that's sad.
No, I'm the one in charge. It's my TV.
You have the remote.
Exactly.
You control the...
I'm the man. We do record it so she can watch it later. Yeah.
You're getting yourself in trouble. Anyway, so Melissa Gilbert...
She's on Dancing with the Stars.
On Dancing with the Stars. Apparently, she and her partner... Maxim. Yes.
Yeah.
They apparently are like the forerunners or have been considered one of the better couples
oh, yeah.
of all Dancing with Stars time. And she hit her head during a dip and received a concussion last week.
Oh my goodness.
Which they missed showing because they were busy showing Maxim falling and landing on his rear. So he was okay. But she did hit her head, got a concussion, and they announced at the end of the episode she was going to the hospital.
Oh,
so
no.
She sat out during the results on Tuesday.
Really?
Yeah.
Is so she okay?
She's okay, but she did, for caution.
I've gotten a concussion before. Have you ever gotten a concussion?
No, I can imagine you would, though. I feel like you probably had an aggressive childhood. I don't know.
No, actually, I was an adult. Thank you very much. I was playing football, and I dove. Fourth down. Okay. It's fourth down, and I'm running for the first down marker, and I dive for the first down marker. Now, we're not wearing pads or anything. This is flag ball, but we can dive. Anyway, so I dove for the first down.
And you have
down,
to, because you're a dude.
But there was a guy in my way, so I had to turn and dive. And he didn't pull my flag, which is great. But then I hit my head, and I got really, really dazed, and the whole thing. And I didn't black out, lose consciousness, but I played for apparently another 10 minutes. And then I looked around, and I started to wonder where I was. And I said, where am I? I don't like this. Where am I? I don't. Apparently, they said, I said, where am I? And I don't like this, like 30 times. And so they said, all right, we're stopping the game, and took me home and the whole thing. And this whole fogginess felt that way for about 2 hours. But
here's they took you home? You didn't go to the hospital?
No, they just, because it was a mild concussion, because I didn't lose consciousness.
Yeah.
I lost memory, though. I have memory loss of about 10 minutes. The cool thing, made the first down. I made the first down, I did. But yeah, no, I lost 10 minutes, and concussions are... They can be a little on the scary side, you know. They can be a little on the scary side.
Yeah, I can imagine so.
I'm glad I was able to tell you that story.
I'm glad you're okay.
Yeah, I'm glad that, what's her name, is okay.
Melissa Gilbert.
Right, I don't care. Go ahead.
So mean. So, also the bad, Hunger Games director Gary Ross will not be returning for the sequel.
What?
So this may or may not be bad. This could be good. There could be, you know,
well, now this happened to Twilight too, didn't it?
Yes, and to Harry Potter. It's completely, I mean, they've all gone different.
Mm-hmm. But from the first to the second, though, because that's what happened to Twilight. The first Twilight was one director. The second Twilight, bigger budget, different director.
Okay, well, and the reasoning for this, some people said it was money because he was asking for more money. He got a relatively small salary payout compared to directors of films this size because the actual original budget was relatively on the smaller side.
Yeah.
So he wasn't asking for that much to begin with. Well, now he and Lionsgate have been scuffling over this for a while now, but apparently, supposedly, was not because of the money. It was more of like a power political struggle type thing. Lionsgate wanted to give him, it only would have given 4 months for the writers to come up with a script.
Ooh.
Because of the release date, which the release date is still 15 months away or something like that. But for the movie to be made.
In order to film and the whole thing.
Yes, for all of that.
You're an actress, you know about these things.
Of course I do. Yeah, post-production takes a long time.
Mm-hmm. Especially with something that has a lot of
special
effects
and the second one will probably have even more. Yeah, there's a lot that goes into that. So it's bad news, but it could end up being good. We don't know who they're...
Bad news for him, though.
Yeah, he'll be missing out on that. Yeah. Hopefully he'll get something good out of it. But
I've heard mixed reviews on Hunger Games. You gave it a positive one, but other people have said nothing.
What have you heard?
Well, just that I don't think they like the premise of the movie.
Well,
like children murdering children.
Well, for that, I would say... I think it helps a lot to read the book ahead of time because the book is more about, it's not about that.
Right.
It's about conquering that, like fighting that system. The
now
system
they didn't say
that
there was a they had a problem with the acting or whatever. I think it was more just the story and the whole thing that people had a problem with. But that that's just what people have said. I've not read the book or seen the movie yet, so we'll see.
Let me know when you finally get around to that in like 7 years. Once the third movie's out
and
you finally catch up.
I watched Lord of the Rings in 3 years. And I hadn't read the book yet.
You watched it in order as it came out?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, that's good. Mm-hmm. That's redemption, then. You can't even compare the two. Loader's like way up here and Hunger Games is over here somewhere.
That's the Loader?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you a Loader geek?
I don't know
what
you're
talking
about.
Geek? Is that what
anyway, so The Ugly. Moving on. Britney Spears will be making $15 million for being a judge on The X Factor.
She joined The X Factor?
She is now.
Oh, man. She joined The X Factor.
She joined The X Factor.
That's huge.
After Simon has fired his last two judges.
Yeah, which included
Nicole
Scherzinger.
And Paula. Yeah.
And Paula. But Paula Abdul's gone too. Yeah. So he got Britney Spears on the show, and that's ugly.
That is ugly to me. No, not so much Britney, though. Girl's kind of crazy.
As a talent scout, though, she might be good.
She could be fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, we will see. Just the fact that someone's getting paid $15 million to sit on a show once
like
a week
that.
And judge. Yeah. Anyway. But prior to that, that makes her the highest paid judge on TV. So I guess she wins.
So J-Lo didn't get...
J-Lo gets $12 million for American Idol.
Oh. Mm-hmm. So Britney Spears gets the most... Like, she needs the money, too.
I know. Like, she's not already rolling in it.
What the heck is that? That's gross.
And then Courtney Love has accused Foo Fighters lead for hitting on her daughter via Twitter, which, of course...
How old is her daughter?
19.
Oh, pfft.
Yeah. I know, right?
She's just mad because Dave Grohl and she have been in fights over the songs for Nirvana since he died.
She's just mad because she's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah. Basically, she's crazy.
She is rather insane.
She looks like a coke addict. And
she does. She definitely has the look.
She's just really awful.
It's rough.
But so what? I mean, is her daughter attractive? And do they know each other? And
they've communicated some.
I mean, Dave Grohl's a little old.
Yeah, her daughter, of course, said this is crazy, and that Twitter should ban my mother from Twitter.
Wow.
Because this is not the first time that Courtney, of course, has bashed Dave via Twitter prior. So it's not the first outburst she has had.
Yeah. She doesn't like Dave Grohl, and Dave Grohl just laughs. He just laughs.
Yeah.
Because he's doing great. Foo Fighters won another Grammy this year. And yeah.
And he said, you know, this is...
It's really sad, though.
Yeah.
Courtney Love used to be...
Awesome.
She was a good singer. Mm-hmm. She was a rock
Beautiful.
And roll. And she was kind of respectable.
Yeah.
She was an actress. She was in the movie Man on the Moon with Jim Carrey, and she was great in that movie. She had a lot of potential, and she just turned into a skank, basically.
Don't tell us how you really feel.
Yeah, I know. I didn't hear you say that the autopsy came out about Whitney Houston. You haven't said anything about that.
No, I have not. Do you want to say something about
that? No, I'll let you find it and then decide on whether or not you want to report on it. It's a little sad, yeah.
Because I had heard prior something about that there were drugs and there was...
Well,
was
there
drowning,
certainly was,
but
it was even worse than that. It was like...
Now you're just going to leave them hanging.
Whitney Houston died here recently, and it was a drowning.
It was ruled a drowning.
Ruled a drowning, but she had cocaine in her system because she was doing drugs, and apparently the scene was like from a really bad, you know, drug movie or something. She was found face down in the bathtub. Blood was coming out of her nose. There was, like, pills and...
I hope children aren't watching.
So anyway, it was a bad scene. So it was a little rough.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's kind of a bad note to leave on.
That was really...
That was the ugliest
low.
Of the ugly
that was
right
pretty,
there.
That would be, very ugly.
What is good, however, The Avengers is coming out this week.
Yeah.
Oh, well, it's coming out
May
soon.
May 4th, so soon.
May 4th, so a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
And then we get The Avengers. That's more important to talk about.
Yes.
And hopefully, if we have not completely run you off from all of our depressing talk, you will be with us when we get back, because I do have the things that matter. Stick around.
Discover great local programming right here on WTMB East Tennessee Television. Tune in weekday mornings at 6:30 a.m. for Tennessee Valley This Morning to find out what's going on in your local area. Watch East Tennessee Shopper with Joe and Kim Palo live every Monday night from 7 to 8 p.m. Get caught up in all the latest sports action. Watch In the Spotlight with Brittany Jackson Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. with replays at midnight. All this and more on WTMB East Tennessee Television.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dennis Ford, board certified in anti-aging medicine and pain management. Have you had recent decrease in energy, lack of sex drive, feel moody, grumpy, or sad? If so, you may have low testosterone and be a candidate for bioidentical hormone replacement. Listen to what two of my patients have to say.
Before I came to the Ford Clinic, I had to have a nap every day.
When I got off work, I'd lay around, really didn't want to do much, and felt real lazy.
I've noticed since I had the testosterone implant that I could go a good 8 hours doing the things I enjoy doing.
I had it done, took about 25, 30 minutes, 5 months, and I'm doing good. My stomach, my muscles, they've completely changed. My fat level has dropped. Get to go out and run, exercise with my son. My muscles are just getting stronger.
If you'd like to change your life, please call me at Ford Center for Pain Management and Anti-Aging Medicine at 423-400-9115.
Very simple process and is well worth it.
I'm Byron Winters with Landmark Insurance Brokerage. Contact me for all of your business insurance needs. From general liability to workers' comp, commercial auto, and business umbrellas, Landmark Insurance has you covered.
Welcome back. If you've actually been able to come back and you're still willing to brave this show,
thank you for
a little while longer, we have the things that matter. Sarah, a Vietnamese traffic cop went on a wild ride in Hanoi. That's in Vietnam. Clinging to the windshield wipers of a moving bus for nearly a kilometer.
Whoa.
After the rogue driver tried to avoid a ticket, police said Friday. Traffic police Second Lieutenant Nguyen Man Phan ordered the bus driver to pull over the 39-seat passenger coach Monday, said another police officer in Hanoi. The driver allegedly refused to show his paperwork and drove off, but not before Phan leapt onto the front. And the officer said the bus reached a top speed of about 50 kilometers per hour, which is about 31 miles an hour.
Oh my goodness.
But he was intent on giving this bus driver a ticket. And so he jumped onto the, and they have a picture online. They jumped onto the front and he's like standing there holding on to the bus and he's got the ticket and he's trying to put the ticket underneath the windshield wiper. It's hilarious. But can you believe that?
No.
That's a man devoted to his work.
Yes, that is impressive.
A California weightlifter. This is a little...
This is
kind of dear into my heart.
Yeah.
Says he accidentally shot himself by dropping a dumbbell on a bullet. I'm sorry, I don't know what to say. The man was wounded in the shoulder. He told Modesto police officers he was lifting dumbbells in his home Wednesday night when he dropped one on a .22 caliber bullet. The man's name hasn't been released. I wouldn't release my name either if I could help it. So he's sitting there and he's pumping
first
iron.
First he was pumping iron with bullets, just like straight bullets around his garage floor.
No, like what in the world?
No, I mean just...
He's just got bullets on the ground.
He didn't clean up after a shooting practice earlier. This man.
So then he's like pumping iron, and then he just drops one. There you go.
And it
shoots him in the shoulder. I here's what I think. I think he's working out, and his wife got mad at him. He's like, listen, you were working out all this time, and you need to be taking out the trash. And he's like, no, honey, it's my bulging biceps.
It's because I'm working out.
Like, she's like, you know what? Shoot him in the shoulder. That's what I think happened. It's a domestic violence case, really. And he was saying.
Oh, I just dropped it.
I was working out. It's because I'm so strong that I got shot in the shoulder. It wasn't because my wife shot me. You get me on that?
I love it. It's great. Macho.
That's right. Which, you know, if you were doing powerlifting like I do.
Yes, that
macho
would be an
issue. Is unnecessary.
No, it's about the skill.
We're ooze masculinity so much, we don't feel the need to tell everybody because everybody already knows. Right? Don't answer. Okay. This is a sad story. Firefighters used chainsaws, hazmat suits, and a flatbed truck to cut and haul out a 600-pound man from his Pennsylvania home.
Oh, no.
Took a group effort to break in. The mess in the Upper Burl Township home was so bad that there was no clear path to the man. Firefighters used a pulley system to lift the 600-pound man out of the home and place him on a flatbed truck. And apparently he had to go to the hospital. And so they had to do this. Can you imagine being so fat, so obese, that the only way that you can get out is by calling the fire department?
That's insane and so sad.
Yeah.
I can't imagine being lifted from your bed in a pulley. That's just...
Yeah. It's bad. I'm speechless. Apparently
you
are too.
I hope the next one's more cheerful than that.
Oh, it totally is.
Okay, good.
The hottest new discovery in the beer world may actually be frozen. That's because a team of inventors at the Japanese brewing giant Kirin have figured out how to create frozen foam, beer foam, and dispense it on top of a beer like soft serve ice cream.
Whoa.
The innovation has chilling implications for the beer industry. As the foam is frozen to 23 degrees Fahrenheit and the air is continuously blown onto it, or into it, excuse me, to fluff it up. When the literally ice-cold beer is placed into regular unfrozen beer, it acts as an insulating lid and keeps the drink cold for 30 minutes. So what they found is beer ice is basically what this is. And then what they do is they put it on top of the beer, mm-hmm. and this chills the beer, but it also insulates it because it's foam.
Yeah.
It insulates it from any of the surrounding air, and that keeps the beer cold for a lot longer.
I'm fascinated.
I want them to do that with Dr. Pepper.
That would be wonderful.
I love Dr. Pepper, and I'd like to see them do that. But see, Dr. Pepper doesn't have the same head that a beer does.
No, beer, I mean, you can get a good...
Yeah. Yeah, like Sam Adams, that you know, they do this, the head test, where they have the beer and they have the head and then they take the bottle cap and they put it on top. If it falls through, beer's not any good. Mm-hmm. If it sits on top of the head, it'll just stay there. That's good head on a beer.
What's your next?
You don't want to talk about this anymore, do you?
Though that it sounds awesome.
It sounds so awesome.
May or may not enjoy beer, so...
A custodial employee working on Saturday found a shake-and-bake meth lab in the women's restroom at a store Alabama. Yes. The single-use methamphetamine operation included a Nestle water bottle and five empty packets of over-the-counter cold medicine Sudafedrin. So here's
Which is no longer over-the-counter.
Here's how you make a meth lab.
Please,
you take a water bottle... And then you pump it full of chemicals, and then you take some Sudafedrin, throw that in there, you shake it all up.
Then it explodes in your face.
And then it explodes, and then you put it in a syringe and you shoot it in there. Actually, I have no idea if that's how you
make that. Yeah, that wasn't a very accurate description, but I'm glad that you didn't give a proper
one. But I'm telling you, when it's getting to this point where you have to take a water bottle and do it in a Walmart bathroom...
That's rough.
That's when I think you need to re-examine your life.
Possibly, yeah.
You know what I mean? I mean, are you really that hard up to have the energy to clean your house or something? Because that's what people do with people on meth. They just clean all the time.
Yeah, it's cleaning.
Because it's an amphetamine, which means it's a stimulant, which mm-hmm. means they just go. You know, kind of like cocaine.
Cocaine is not drug lesson.
Cocaine is not anywhere near as bad as meth, though. Meth is.
It's not as life-destroying, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, plus the high is different. If you have kids, please remove them from the room.
I was going to say, this is drug lesson with Matthew.
I think maybe I need to stop doing this. My name is Matt. Those are the things that matter. We'll be right back. That's a little disturbing. My goodness gracious.
Kathy Guy with Landmark Insurance Brokerage. Call us today for all your personal insurance needs. With 28 years in the insurance business, I have the solutions and pricing you are looking for. At Landmark Insurance Brokerage, we've got you covered.
Discover great local programming right here on WTMB East Tennessee Television. Tune in weekday mornings at 6:30 a.m. for Tennessee Valley This Morning to find out what's going on in your local area. Watch East Tennessee Shopper with Joe and Kim Palo live every Monday night from 7 to 8 p.m. Be caught up in all the latest sports action. Watch In the Spotlight with Brittany Jackson, Wednesdays at 6:30 p.m. with replays at midnight. All this and more on WTNB East Tennessee Television.
Hi, I'm Dr. Dennis Ford, board certified in anti-aging medicine and pain management. Have you had recent decrease in energy, lack of sex drive, feel moody, grumpy, or sad? If so, you may have low testosterone and be a candidate for bioidentical hormone replacement. Listen to what two of my patients have to say.
Before I came to the Ford Clinic, I had to have a nap every day.
When I got off work, I'd lay around, really didn't want to do much, and felt real lazy.
I've noticed since I had the testosterone implant that I could go a good 8 hours doing the things I enjoy doing.
I had it done, took about 25, 30 minutes, 5 months, and I'm doing good. My stomach, my muscles, they've completely changed. My fat level has dropped. I get to go out and run, exercise with my son. My muscles are just getting stronger.
If you'd like to change your life, please call me at Ford Center for Pain Management and Anti-Aging Medicine at 423-400-9115.
Very simple process and is well worth it.
Yeah, Sarah just said good luck, and I think we need it. I just, from the bottom of my heart, want to apologize. I think I do better when I'm angry rather than
He's
when
too
I'm happy.
Today.
I'm just too happy
it's
today.
Throwing him off.
I do want to invite you back to the show next week. It will be a lot better. That being said, I do want to make an announcement about Boogie at the Barn. It's an Armed Forces Day celebration. It's a fundraising event for the Southeast Tennessee Veterans Home. Saturday, May 19th. That's about a month away. May 19th, 2012 at Pappy's Place. There'll be novelty booths and fun and food and things like that. Lots of music. You're going to have Hard Boiled, Dexter Thomas, Collins Brothers. There's a lot of that. It's boogieatthebarn.com. If you're interested, you can check it out, boogieatthebarn.com. Or you can call 614-0900 for tickets. Tickets are anywhere from $15 if you get them ahead of time, or at the gate, they're $20. So if you want to go out and celebrate and help support the Veterans Home in Southeast Tennessee, which I think is a very nice thing to be able to go and do because of how much our veterans do help us. I mean, you have a friend who's going into the military right now. So Boogie at the Barn on May 19th, boogieatthebarn.com if you're interested. So, Sarah, how are we going to do this next week? Are we going to do better next week?
We'll see. I hope so.
I think we'll be
we
able
can
to
improve.
Do a lot better. It's been very nice to see you again, though.
I'm glad. Yeah, that 2 weeks was really long,
yeah,
wasn't it?
I went through withdrawals. Sarah Anderson withdrawal. So totally. But do you have a favorite person?
My favorite person is Kayla Stevens, my friend who is off to literally getting on the bus for boot camp right now. So.
That's fabulous. Mm-hmm. Fabulous.
She will do a great job in the military.
I bet she would. Military is really a great... this last weekend, I got to meet a guy named Wes Moore. He wrote a book called The Other Wes Moore. But he was in the military for a really... I don't know how long he was in there, but he went like 2 or 3 tours, I guess, to Afghanistan and Iraq and stuff like that. Now he's on TV and he's doing a lot of... making the rounds and he's doing all that stuff. But... I have a lot of respect. I wish I had considered. I did not consider it when I was in high school thinking about what I was going to do. I did not consider going to the military, and I wish I had.
So who's your favorite person?
My favorite person is going to be you today, Sarah. I'm glad you're back. Did Jennifer just laugh?
She laughed.
Did you just hear her laugh?
Yeah, she did. It's okay.
Thought that was kind of hilarious.
It is hilarious.
We are going to sign off right now.
And, you guys have a great week, though.
You have a wonderful week. We will be back next week, however. And Ryerson may even make an appearance himself.
We won't make any drug references.
No drug references. We'll just stay away from drugs altogether next week.
Let's do that. That's probably, stay away from drugs, Matt.
Probably a good idea. And you should probably follow that advice as well. Drugs are bad. Have a wonderful day. It's a little stormy, but it should be all right. Take care. See you later. Bye-bye.